Hello and welcome back to another video about breathing, and in particular how to stop the water from going up your nose as you swim. This is a popular problem that a lot of beginner swimmers face, and we're going to talk about it in this video. What works, what doesn't work, what you should do, and what you should avoid. Okay, so stay tuned, let's get started. So first of all, if you are having problems with water going up your nose and hitting your sinuses and just giving you that wasabi sensation of pain up here, it's normal for a beginner. I remember when I was a kid, I would snort tons of water up my nose, I would swallow tons of water. It happens to the best of us. We're doing so many things at once. It's juggling your arms, your legs, your body position in the water, your head, your shoulder, your where you're going, everything. If you snort water or if you swallow water by accident, it's normal because, again, you can't handle so many things going at the same time. It's the ultimate multitask compared to, like, say, running. Let's talk about some short-term solutions that I've seen from so many other people advocate that does not work. So what I'm talking about is nose plugs. They're basically these clips that you put on your nose and it just seals off your nasal passage. I would say to avoid them at all costs, unless you are one of these three swimmers. You are either a scuba diver, a synchronized swimmer, or you are a backstroker. Scuba divers, their nose passages are blocked because they get all their oxygen through a tank. Synchronized swimmers, they spend most of their time upside down in the water. They gotta really control their breathing. Backstrokers, yes, you do need to wear a nose clip because when you do backstroke, there's no exhaling through the nose involved. If you're one of these three swimmers, then you should wear a nose clip. But if you're outside of these three, then stay away from nose clips because they are a short-term solution, especially when your face is in the water doing breaststroke, front crawl, or butterfly. We don't need a nose clip to block our nasal passage because when we do these strokes, front crawl, breaststroke, butterfly, most of our exhaling goes throughout our nose. And I'll tell you why. When you breathe throughout through your mouth, it's a conscious effort. So think about it. Just try doing that. Breathe in through your mouth, breathe out through your mouth. You notice how much effort is involved when you breathe out using your mouth? Now, I want you to try to breathe in through your mouth and breathe out through your nose. Which one's easier, breathing out through your mouth or breathing out through your nose? I would say 99.9% of us would choose breathing out through the nose. It's a lot easier. When you breathe steady bubbles in the water using your mouth, you're clenching your mouth a little bit. You feel it right here when you do this motion. Now try timesing that 10,000 times when you're doing continuous lap swimming. You're gonna feel that. So breathing out through the nose doesn't involve tensing any muscles, right? It's just... Second thing is, when you breathe out through your nose, you can prolong it versus breathing out through your mouth. Right? So if I wanted to extend my breath using my mouth, I would have to really concentrate and tense my mouth muscles in order to mimic what I do with my nose so effortlessly. Breathing out through the nose is a lot easier and you can do it a lot longer. And that's working for us when we do breaststroke or front crawl, because when we do the front crawl, we don't just put one arm in. We usually put a minimum of two. One, two, breathe. Okay, and that's for sprint swimmers. When you're doing continuous lap swimming, the average is three arms. One, two, three, and then breathe. Okay, we can extend it to five or seven or nine, whatever. So in order to do three strokes, we need to exhale for quite a long period of time, okay? And we have to do it in a way that's easy on our system. If I wanted to do three arms with the mouth, just watch. That's easy for the first try, but again, you gotta think long term. When you're doing continuous lap swimming, you gotta times it by 10,000. Doing this 10,000 times, it's gonna build up. It's gonna take its toll on you, on your mouth. Now do that. Same thing, breathing out through the nose. It's a lot easier on the system. Just try it out at home. Test it out for yourself. I want you to run on a treadmill or run outside for at least 1 minute. And I want you to pay attention to your breathing. I want you to note what you do, what you use as you breathe in and breathe out. For me, I usually breathe in and breathe out naturally through my mouth. So when I'm jogging, I like this. Maybe for you it's different. Maybe it's breathe in through the nose and breathe out through the mouth. Now, I want you to run for 10 minutes. I want you to pay attention to your breathing again. What does it look like? Are you consistently breathing through your nose and then out through your mouth? So are you doing this? For 10 minutes? Or are you switching it up? Are you inconsistent? Because when you jog for 10 minutes, not 1 minute, 10 minutes, then you start to notice the cracks. Your breathing starts to change or switch up. And that's because like, the longer you go, the more your cardiovascular system is being tested. And the same thing goes with swimming. When we do like the first round of first lap of front crawl, it's like, yeah, that's warm up. Once we get into like the 25th lap, 26th lap, that's when we really test our like stamina and how consistent our breathing is will determine how long we can swim for. What we want to develop is consistency. We want a breathing pattern that we keep from the beginning all the way to the end. So if you really want to swim more than one lap, two laps, three laps, to 100 laps, your breathing pattern has to be just like totally predictable from start to finish. I want you to try this test. On the treadmill, I want you to jog, breathing in through the mouth and breathing out through the nose. I know it's tough because this method, this exercise is going to teach you how to relearn how to breathe. Because most of you, I bet, have been breathing in through the nose and out through the mouth as you run. I want you to reverse it. Okay, when you're on the treadmill, I want you to breathe in through the mouth and out through the nose. Do it for at least 10 minutes. It's gonna be hard in the beginning. It's uncomfortable, especially when you're on the treadmill, but try it. Second exercise I want you to practice on the treadmill is only the mouth. No nose, just the mouth. It takes time for your body to relearn how to breathe, but you really need to, yeah, change things up if you really want to get through this hurdle of snorting water up your nose. For beginner swimmers, I don't teach any of them how to breathe out through the nose in the beginning. I teach them how to breathe in through the mouth and blow their bubbles out through the mouth. Why do I teach them that? Well, instead of teaching two things at the same time, mouth and nose, I just stick to just one thing. In the beginning, master one thing first, and then you can progress on to two things. Doesn't that make sense? Take a step back and focus on just breathing in and breathing out with the mouth. It takes a lot more effort, but again, sometimes we need to take a step back. These are my tips that I can give you on how to avoid water going up the nose. Okay? For me, it was just a gradual process. It was just me, my body adapting. There became a point where my body finally learned its lesson and said, stop, okay? Here's the shutoff valve, okay? No more water going up the sinuses. Water up the nose, bad. And if you want a free cheat sheet on how to swim, 25 pro tips, the link is down below to get your copy right now. So click that link down below. Get your free cheat sheet. My name's Justin. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you later. Okay, take care. Bye-bye.